Hello friends, today let us look at a very important experiment wherein an alternating current is converted into DC current or voltage. The experiment is known as full wave rectifier experiment. As all of us know, a diode is having a unidirectional property. This unidirectional property of the diode makes it useful as a rectifier. Now, a rectifier is a circuit which converts AC into DC. Basically, there are different types of rectifiers: half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier. In full wave, again two types: full wave rectifier and full wave bridge rectifier. Today, I am going to discuss about full wave bridge rectifier, which requires four junction diodes to be connected in a bridge fashion, in the form of a bridge. Let me show you that particular circuit first. So this is a full wave rectifier circuit, bridge rectifier circuit, wherein four junction diodes are connected in the form of a bridge. See, this is the first diode, diode D1, diode D2, diode D3 and diode D4. N regions of the diodes D1 and D2 are connected together. Again, P regions of the diodes D4 and D3 are connected together. This point is taken as ground. This is the point wherein, from which we take the output. And these are the two inputs to the rectifier circuit. From the rectifier circuit, the connection is given to a milliammeter, to a key, then a rheostat, and then ground. Now, this milliammeter reads the output current, and also a multimeter connected across the rheostat or across the load reads the voltage across the rheostat. Now, if you switch on the circuit, the output from the transformer is connected here, A and B. This is in the AC form. This alternating voltage is connected across the bridge circuit, and here the output will be rectified output. Rectified means output will be having fluctuations in the DC level only, and this is known as rectified output. And the overall action of the circuit is that AC is converted into pulsating DC. Now let us look into the actual circuit. Now here we have the source, AC source, transformer output 12 0 12, and this is the bridge circuit. This is done as per this circuit. From this bridge circuit, connection is given to a milliammeter, then a key, then the rheostat, then again to the ground. So this is how the circuit is completed. A multimeter is connected across the rheostat to note down the output voltage, and also this milliammeter connected in series measures the current through the circuit. To proceed with the experiment, initially the circuit is switched on. Rheostat is adjusted in such a way that there is some current in the circuit, say 100 milliamps. Now 100 milliamps current passes through the circuit, and now the voltage across the load is, DC voltage across the load is somewhat 10.54 volts. So this is the pulsating DC developed across the load. In the same manner, you can, for the same current, you can measure the AC voltage across the load. So this measures the AC voltage across the load. Now AC voltage nearly 22 volts. So what I would like to say is that in case of rectifier circuit, output consists of both voltages, DC voltage and AC voltage, or in other words we say output consists of ripples or fluctuations. Now the magnitude of these ripples is estimated by means of a parameter known as ripple factor, which is nothing but the ratio between magnitude of AC voltage and DC voltage. Now this, the circuit is simple circuit without any filters. Now if you use different types of filters, AC component will be reduced, and also output will be in the pure DC form. Now to proceed with the experiment, the initial current 10 milliamps is changed, and 100 milliamps is changed to say 110 milliamps. Accordingly, the voltage also changes. both the DC voltage and AC voltage change across the load. So all these values are tabulated, and finally for each current we can calculate the ripple factor as gamma equal to VAC by VDC. Experiment is repeated for another current, say 120 or 130 or 140, etc., depending on the case, and correspondingly voltages are also measured, DC voltage and AC voltage. In each case ripple factor is estimated. If you analyze the ripple factor so obtained, what you get is that with the rise in the circuit current, output current, ripple factor also goes on increasing, which means if you draw more and more current from the circuit, more AC components will be there or ripple will be more. Now the question is how to reduce these ripple factors. These ripple factor or the AC components are reduced by using filter circuits. Normally capacitor or an inductor or both are used as filter circuits. In the next part we are going to talk about these filter circuits. In order to reduce the AC components in the rectifier output, we make use of filter circuits. This capacitor is one of the filter, which means only AC can pass through the capacitor. Whenever such capacitor is connected across the load, whatever the components of AC which are present in the rectifier output are grounded, resulting in constant output DC. Now let us connect this capacitor across the load like this. Circuit is switched off and the longer edge of the capacitor is to be connected to positive side, shorter edge is connected to the ground. So this is how the connection is made. Across the load the capacitor is connected. Now this becomes a full wave rectifier circuit with capacitor filter. Here the capacitor used grounds the AC components which are present in the rectifier output. Now the experiment is repeated in the same manner. Circuit is switched on, current is fixed at 100 milliamps like this, and the voltage is measured, particular DC voltage is measured as before. In the same manner AC voltage is measured, it is like this. So what you can see is that if you connect a capacitor across the load, AC components will be reduced and therefore ripple factor will be reduced. There is another filter circuit known as the inductor filter. So this is an inductor, this is nothing but a coil. Here what is done is the output current is made to pass through this coil. The property of the inductor is that this opposes the fluctuations, which means this stops fluctuations, stops AC passing through that. Therefore output will be again filtered. If you use both the filters together, the circuit is known as LC filter, wherein you have double filtration. One filtration takes place by the capacitor, another filtration will be by the inductor. Therefore output will be almost constant, just like DC. Now let us insert this inductor in the circuit like this. Output is taken through the inductor like this. Circuit to the inductor, inductor to milliammeter. Rest of the things are like that only. Capacitor is already fixed. Now output is filtered two times, partly filtered by the capacitor, partly filtered by the inductor. As before, the circuit is analyzed and the experiment is done. Current is fixed at 100 milliamps. Output DC voltage is noted. This is the DC output voltage. Similarly, AC voltage is noted. In each case, ripple factor is calculated, and the ripple factor so obtained is to be compared with the ripple factor with no filter, with C filter and LC filter. You will see that ripple factor goes on decreasing as you add more and more filters. And for a given filter, ripple factor goes on increasing if you draw more and more current. And all these values, observations are tabulated, and finally you can estimate the percentage regulation of the circuit for different filters, for no filter, for C filter and for LC filter. Now let me go through the tabular column of this particular experiment. So here you can see a capacitor filter connected across the load. This is C filter, this is LC filter, inductor and C together, and finally this is known as pi section filter, wherein you make use of two capacitors and an inductor. So in the last case, in this pi section case, there will be triple filtration, means AC is stopped, AC is filtered by three components, capacitor 1, inductor and another capacitor. Now the values are tabulated here. This first column gives different currents, and this is voltage DC for different currents, voltage AC for different currents, and here the ripple factor VAC by VDC for no filter. For the same current, VDC and VAC are calculated for C filter, and also ripple factor is estimated, and for LC filter, VDC and VAC are measured, ripple factor is estimated. For pi filter, VDC and VAC are measured, for the same current, ripple factor is estimated. And you will see that as you come down for the given filter circuit, or as the current is increased, ripple factor goes on increasing, and as the filters are added, ripple factor goes on decreasing. So this is how to remove unwanted AC components in the rectifier output, and after filtration, the voltage or the power that you get is pure DC, which can be used for any purpose, either to run a radio or anything. This is how an AC is converted into DC using a full wave bridge rectifier circuit. Thank you.